WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 6.
The aftermath of the storm. This is video of just some of the damage left behind. Good evening, everyone. I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Nigel Robertson, in for Michael. Some parts of the upstate were really hit hard by yesterday's severe weather and received a lot of damage.
So much damage that meteorologists from the National Weather Service traveled to those areas today to try to figure out if a tornado is responsible. News 4's Gabrielle Komorowski joins us now. And Gabby, where did they go?
They went to several places, Carol. The meteorologists traveled to Greenville County and also Greenwood County, both places that yesterday around this time were under a tornado warning.
If we do put out a tornado warning and we get damage reports, we usually go and check it out to try to determine whether it was a tornado or just straight line winds.
That's what brought Larry Gabrick to the Greenwood County town of 96. The meteorologist with the National Weather Service takes pictures of the damaged land and toppled trees off Kennard Road. He is examining where these trees toppled.
If you have a concentrated area all in, you know, a compact path of some sort, then it's more of a telltale sign of perhaps a tornado.
The National Weather Service believes that winds at speeds of between 60 and 70 miles per hour caused this damage. Pat Patterson, the emergency management director in Greenwood County, is showing Gabrick some of the places hardest hit. Fortunately, no one was hurt and the property damage was minimal. But Patterson says it was a wild night.
Burst came in here, was very quick and was over in a matter of a half hour. But the intensity of the rain, some hail was here, reported hailing. Just when you get that sort of thing, it's just chaotic at that moment.
Crews spent Tuesday afternoon cleaning up the tree limbs and debris, a mess left behind by a powerful storm. And we learned late this afternoon that meteorologists determined that a tornado did not touch down in Greenwood County. National Weather Service meteorologists are still examining the damage in Greenville County in the Traveler's Rest area to determine if a tornado touched down there. Back to you.
So now let's check in with our meteorologist, John Sestrich.
John, that was a very fast-moving storm.
In fact, this system was moving to the east and southeast at up to 60 miles per hour. So it was just flying along. This is what it looked like at 3:15 yesterday afternoon. Severe thunderstorms just now knocking in on the front door of in extreme western North Carolina and also northwestern Georgia, Cherokee, Clay, and also in through Graham counties. Watch how fast this whole line just continued to make its way off to the east and southeast. Then a solid line. The really nasty thunderstorms really hit Hart and Elbert counties, Abbeville, Greenwood counties, and then Gab was talking about National Weather Service surveying some of the damage in Greenwood County around 96. 60 to 70 mile per hour winds, straight line winds, also some microbursts associated with these. As these thunderstorms collapse, the winds come down, and then as they fan out in all different directions, they blow everything over in one direction. So, and also a tornado just north of Silver Street in southern Newberry County. That was confirmed on EF1. So isolated wind damage across the area, even a few places that had some large hail. Now back to you, Carol.
John, thank you. And as